This video is going to be pretty long, so I will have timestamps in the description laying out where I answer specific questions that may pertain to the current problem that you're having with your phone. And all the materials and softwares that I talk about and use in this video will be in the description, so you can check them all out there. Hey guys, it's Olivia and I'm back with another video. So, the most popular video on my channel is called How to Turn on USB Debugging with a Broken / Black Screen. And the reason why that video did so well is because I covered a topic that people were searching for and I answered it in a way that no one had before. I showed a new method that, to my knowledge, no one else on the internet had shown. So, therefore, when people watched other people's videos about the topic and it didn't help and then they came over to mine, they were like, oh, finally something different. So that video I uploaded 2 years ago. Then last year I uploaded a part two to that video, showing a different method. Once again, a new method that, to my knowledge, no one else had shown, and that helped even more people. And because it was once again a new method that no one else was talking about, that is my second most popular video. And so this video right here is how to turn on USB debugging with a broken / black screen, part three. And why am I making a part three? Well, basically, no method is perfect. Part one helped a lot of people, but not every single person who watched it. Part two helped a lot of people, but not every single person who watched it. And so those solutions weren't perfect, but no solution is, because there's so many different Android phones from different companies, and also some things could be different depending on what Android version you're running and all this stuff. So no solution is perfect. However, part three isn't a new solution. It's going to be troubleshooting some problems from part one, because part one was not perfect and there are some things that can be tweaked. So basically, if you haven't watched part one, I highly recommend watching it. You can check it out right here, because this is a troubleshoot of part one in case you got stuck, because there were some things that I spoke about in part one but I never physically showed. And so people have been asking questions about it for the past 2 years and I have been replying to them in the comments, but I feel like a visual representation is a lot more helpful than a typed out answer. So I highly recommend checking out part one, because in this video I'm going to keep referencing part one and I'm going to keep referencing what I like to call the screenshot method. And if you haven't watched part one, then you're not going to know what the screenshot method is. And another thing, if you watch part one might be able to help you, so you might not even need all these extra steps. So if you check out part one and it helps you, you don't even need to come back to this video. You can close the window. You don't have to watch to the end. It doesn't matter. As long as I'm able to help, I don't care whether it's part one, two, or three that helps you. I am just here to try and help. So, a quick summary of part one. What is the screenshot method? My method of turning on USB debugging when you couldn't see your screen was plug your phone into your computer and open your screenshots folder and then take a screenshot. View it on your computer screen, and then you're like, okay, this is the part of my phone that I'm in. This is the part of my settings that I'm in. Then you click something. Then you take another screenshot and then you're like, okay, now this is where I am. Then you click something else and then you keep taking a screenshot between each click so that you can see what you're doing. That was my method. However, this method didn't work for some people, because when they plugged their phone into their computer, it didn't show up. And so in this week's video, we're going to talk about one, why your phone didn't show up on your computer, and then two, how to get it to show up on your computer so that you can then follow the screenshot method from part one. So, why isn't your phone showing up on your computer? It can be one of two reasons. One, your phone is locked, or two, your phone isn't on file transfer mode, meaning it can't transfer files. Or three, it could be both. Your phone might be locked and it's not on file transfer mode. And we're going to try and resolve both issues in this video. Once again, no method is perfect, so this might not help everybody, but I'm going to try and help as many people as possible. So now that we know why your phone isn't showing up on your computer, how do we resolve this? This is dependent on a couple of things. So this video is titled How to Turn on USB Debugging with a Broken / Black Screen, assuming that your phone is both black, like you can't see anything on the screen, and it doesn't respond to touch. However, your phone could be one or the other. Maybe you can see your screen, but the touch doesn't work, or maybe you can't see your screen and the touch does work, or maybe you can't do either. So we're gonna discuss all types of broken screens, and we're gonna discuss how to unlock all types of passwords, whether you have a pattern, a PIN, or a word. We're gonna discuss all of it. And so there are gonna be timestamps in the description so you can skip to the part that is specific to the exact problem that you are having. So the first type of broken screen we're gonna talk about is when you can see what you're doing, but the touch input doesn't work. So right here, I have a Sony Xperia. I don't know which one it is. I know it's an old one. This is my brother's like really, really, really old phone, and it's probably like a 7-year-old phone. So this phone, as you can see, the screen is quite cracked and such. And then if I turn it on, you can see that parts of the screen are black and other parts of the screen are visible. So basically it doesn't really respond to touch, and you can see enough of the screen to know what you're doing. So if you have a phone where the screen is still somewhat visible and or fully visible, but it doesn't respond to touch, this is what you need. You need an OTG cable right here. So all the phones that I'm going to be using as examples in this video use micro USB, but the same goes for if your phone uses USB-C, which I know a lot of the new Androids do, and I will have links to the USB-C options of all the cords that I talk about in this video. So for this one, on this end, it has the micro USB or USB-C, depending on which one you buy. And then on the other end, it will have a regular USB-A like most computers have. So what you're gonna do is you're going to plug the cable into the bottom of your phone, and then you need a USB mouse. So whether you have a mouse like this where it's just the USB is separate and then they communicate, or whether you have one with a cord, it doesn't matter, but it needs to be a USB mouse that you can plug in. So then you take the USB and you plug it into the other end. And as you can see, there is a cursor on the screen. So then what you're gonna do is click the mouse and drag. And then I don't know if you can see the dots, but this phone happens to have a pattern on it. So then you're going to use the mouse to draw the pattern. And now you're in your phone and it should show up on your computer because it is now unlocked. So if you are a person who you can see your phone screen but you just couldn't touch anything, then you don't need to use the screenshot method because you can see what's happening on your phone screen. But basically, if your phone wasn't showing up because it was locked, then all you have to do is unlock it, and now that your phone is unlocked, now when you plug it into your computer, it will show up, assuming your phone isn't on charging only mode, which we will get to that a little bit later. But yeah, so if your issue was, oh, my phone is locked and you could see the screen but you just couldn't touch it, well then buy an OTG cable, plug a mouse into your phone, unlock it, and now plug your unlocked phone into your computer, and now you can transfer your data if that's what you wanted to do, or if you wanted to turn on USB debugging so that you can control your phone through Visor, you can now go through your phone settings and turn on USB debugging. Or at this point, you might not even need Visor because you could just plug your mouse into the phone and use it that way, but that is completely up to you. And let's say that you had a PIN password and or a word password, you can swipe with the mouse and then click the individual letters, or you can swipe with the mouse and click the individual numbers for your PIN. So you can use the mouse to do everything that you need to do. Now, moving on to the second type of broken screen, if you cannot see your screen, but the touch input works. So for my example, I have this Note 2. This is the same phone that I used in the first video. So if you guys have seen that video, then you know that it doesn't respond to touch with my fingers. However, it does respond to touch with the stylus. I can't see what I'm touching, but it does work. So what do we do in this instance? When you want to type your PIN and or your password, but you can't see the letters and or numbers, this is what you do. For the purpose of you being able to see what's going to go on your phone, I'm going to use this phone. This is a Galaxy S5 Neo, and I'm just using this to show you what will be happening on your phone screen. So what you're going to do is you're going to need the same OTG cable. You're going to plug it into the phone, and then you're going to plug a USB keyboard into the phone. So then we're going to plug this into the other side. So what you're going to do is the keyboard shows up. You're going to click enter on the keyboard to act as your swipe. And then there's your PIN. Then you're going to put in your PIN. So for this phone, I just put the PIN as 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you're going to click enter again to click OK. And now you're in the phone. Now the phone is unlocked. That is what will be happening. You're not going to be able to see that happening, but that's what's going to happen. So I didn't touch the screen at all. Let's just do it again. You're going to like click your sleep wake button. You're going to click enter. You're going to type your PIN, and then you're going to click enter again, and then your phone will be unlocked, and then you can plug it into your computer and take your screenshots, because remember, we can't actually see the phone screen. So you're going to plug it into your computer and take your screenshots. Now unplug it from the keyboard, because now you're in your phone, and then you're going to take your phone charger, which is plugged into your computer, and you're going to plug it into your phone, and now it should show up on your computer screen because your phone is unlocked. And so now you can't see your screen, but it's still responsive to touch. So now you're going to take a screenshot and view it on your computer, and then you're going to touch something. Let's say we touch that, but we can't see that we touched that. So then we take another screenshot, then we look at it on our computer, and we're like, okay, now we're here. Let's swipe. Take a screenshot. Oh, that's not the page I wanted to go to. Swipe back. And so basically between each swipe, between each touch, you're going to take a screenshot to see where you are in your phone's menu. And now your phone is unlocked, so you can actually view your screenshots on your computer. Now for the biggest problem of them all, which a lot of you might be having, if your phone screen is black and it isn't responsive to touch. This is what you are going to need. You are going to need a splitter cable. So the splitter cable that I'm going to link in the description is going to look something like this. This is an aux splitter, so it's not going to have these ends on it, but basically it's going to have one end that plugs into your phone, another end where you can plug in a mouse or a keyboard, and then another end where you plug in your charger so that you can plug your phone into your computer. So the reason I show you this is just to show yours is going to be dangly like this, but for the purpose of this video, I am going to use this. This is a USB hub. You don't need this. This is from my part two, and it's going to work the same way as a splitter cable. So since I already own this, I didn't buy a splitter cable, but the one that I'm going to link below is going to work the same. So basically, all you need is a part that plugs into your phone, a USB, and then a section that looks just like your charger. So this one is a micro USB version, but I will be linking a USB-C version below in case you have a USB-C phone. So what you're going to do if your screen is black and it doesn't respond to touch. So once again, using this one, pretend we don't have a stylus and it doesn't respond to our fingers, which we know from before. So this is what you are going to want to do. You're going to plug in the one end into your phone. Then, assuming you have a PIN or a word password, you are going to plug in a USB keyboard into the USB end. And then finally, you are going to plug your charger into the bottom. So once again, you can't see it, but you're gonna click enter twice, and then you're gonna type your PIN, and then click enter, and then your phone should be unlocked. Then now your phone is unlocked, so it should show up on your computer screen. So now you can view your screenshots, but you still can't touch the screen. So now you plug out the keyboard and you plug in your USB mouse instead. So now you're going to take a screenshot and view it on your computer, and then you're going to use your mouse to make your click, and you're going to say, "Ooh, that's not what I wanted to click." Then go back or swipe back or do whatever you need to do. So you're going to take a screenshot, see where you are, click with the mouse. Take another screenshot, see where you are, click with the mouse. So that's what you're gonna do. If you can see your front phone screen, you only need an OTG cable and a mouse. Those are the only two things that you need. If you can't see your phone screen but it touches, you need a keyboard to type your password. And then after that, you just need to plug your phone directly into your computer so that you can see your screenshots because your phone is now unlocked. And then you can touch with your fingers because your touch works. And then if you can't see your screen and you can't touch, then you need a splitter cable, or in this situation where I'm showing you, I have my hub, but you need something that plugs into your phone and your computer and a mouse at the same time, so that you can first plug in your keyboard and type your password, then plug out your keyboard and plug in your mouse, and now use your mouse as your touch input. I really hope that I explained that well, and I really hope that this all makes sense. For the past year, I've been trying so hard to figure all this out, and I figured it out, but I just hope that I explained it properly. But one thing that I didn't mention in this video was I showed you how to unlock your phone with a pattern password if you could see your phone screen but you just couldn't touch it. So then you plug in the mouse and then you can draw your pattern. If you can't see your phone screen and you have a PIN or a word, then you can just type it on the keyboard. But what do you do if you can't see your screen and you have a pattern password? In all honesty, you just kind of have to guess. So you're gonna have to plug your mouse into your splitter cable and try and draw it. And I know that you can't see where the cursor is, so you can't see what dot you're starting on. So I know that that isn't the most perfect solution. As I've said multiple times in this video, no solution is perfect and no solution will work for everybody. So I know that that isn't the most perfect solution, but that's the only one that I have come up with thus far. For all I know, I might end up having to make a part 4 to this video, and maybe I'll have more things figured out by then, but up until this point, this is what I have figured out. So if you have a PIN or word password and you can't see your screen and or can't touch your screen, you just plug in a keyboard, click enter twice, and then type in your PIN and or word, and then click enter again, and then your phone should be unlocked, and then your phone should show up on your computer. So now let's pretend that all of us got our phones unlocked, whether we have pattern, number, or a word. We all have our phones unlocked at this point. And let's say that your phone still doesn't show up on your computer, which would mean that your phone is on charging only mode. What do you do at that point? If you can see your phone screen, this is what you would do. So right now I'm using a phone that works just so that I can show you a little bit faster. But basically what you would do, but you would be doing this with your mouse, is you would swipe down from the top, and then you see how it says connected as camera. You're gonna click this. And so on the older versions of Android, you had PTP and MTP. What you want is MTP. So then you're going to change it to MTP and now connect it as a media device. And then your phone will now show up on your computer. On the newer versions of Android, once again, I am using a working phone, but you would do this with your mouse. You swipe down from the top
And then it says transfer files because this one is on file transfer mode. If yours is on charge this phone, then it needs to be changed to transfer files, and then now it will show up. So depending on what version of Android you have, you either need to change it to MTP or you need to change it to file transfer. It should not be on PTP or charging only, because then you can't transfer your files. So if you can see your phone screen and then you can use the mouse to change your phone to file transfer mode, that's great. If your phone screen is black, meaning you can't see what you're doing to get to file transfer, and you can't take screenshots because you don't have your file transfer on, then that's where it gets very complicated, and that's where part two could potentially come in handy. Part two does not require you to take any screenshots. It doesn't require you to have access to your phone's files. Part two is basically hooking up your phone to a TV. So as I said, I have this hub, and so you use the HDMI port and the USB port, and so you hook up your phone to a TV, and then you hook up a mouse to this as well. So now your phone is connected to a mouse and the TV, and then you can use the mouse to control your phone and then use the TV to see what you're doing. But the caveat with that is, not only does your phone need to be OTG compatible so that you can use a mouse, but it also needs to be MHL compatible, meaning that it can output its display via HDMI, because not all phones can. So part two requires your phone to have more internal capabilities than part one. Part one, and now this extended version part three, require you to have OTG, and part two requires you to have OTG and MHL, so an extra feature that your phone needs to have. So I know that none of these parts are perfect and they don't answer every single individual person's questions, but I've tried my best to answer as many questions as possible to help as many people as possible. And yeah, that's what you do if you have a password on your phone. The main chunk of this video was, how do I unlock my phone? And so if you have a PIN or a word, you can just type it on your keyboard. And if you have a pattern and you can see your phone screen but you just can't touch it, then you can use a mouse and draw your pattern. Or if you can't see your phone screen, you can guess where your pattern would be. So that's all for this week's video. I hope it was helpful. If you have any more questions, feel free to leave them down below and I will try my best to answer them. And hopefully it doesn't take me another year to make another part, and hopefully I can answer some commonly asked questions more often. But yeah, I hope that I was able to help you a little bit further if you were stuck on how do I unlock my phone and see my screenshots. If this video was helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you think your friends will enjoy it, be sure to share it with them. All my social media links will be down below in case you want to follow me on there. Be sure to subscribe to my channel because I make new videos every Monday, and I'll see you next Monday with a new video.